question number 81. Element X, having atomic number 58, belongs to. Let's have a look on the electronic configuration of this X. Atomic number 58. So first xenon would be there. Atomic number of xenon is 54. That's why I've just left for 54 electrons. 4 electrons are remaining. And the configuration becomes 4F1, 5D1, 6S2. Just recall, this is F block element. And yes, if it is a F block element, we can easily choose option 4. That's my correct answer. Let's take question number 82. Question number 82. 100 ml of 0.1 molar HCl is mixed with 400 ml of 0.4 molar NaOH solution. The pH of the resultant solution will be. The value of log 3 is given for your convenience. So here we have the acid. Let's compare the milli equivalents of HCl. These are 102.1 and the N factor is 1. That's why the milli equivalent in this case becomes 10. Now, the milli equivalents of NaOH, these would be its volume multiplied by molarity, and then N factor is 1 further, so this is 160. It means the excess of NaOH is there, and these are 160 minus 10, it means 150 milli equivalents of NaOH are remaining in the solution. Now let's find out the molarity of NaOH on the basis of this. Molarity of NaOH into its volume into N factor is giving you the milli equivalent. It means in this case 150 is there. This is for NaOH. Now in this case the volume becomes 500 ml, 100 ml of HCl and 400 ml of NaOH. So the total volume becomes 500 ml molarity, and that's equal to 150. So what would be the value of molarity? It is 150 by 500, 15 by 50, or simply it is 0.3 molar. Now this is the molarity of that solution. Let's find out the pH. First we have to find out the pOH value because we have the OH minus ion concentration. Now here it is negative log of 3 into 10 raised to the power minus 1, it would be 0.3, can be represented in this way. Now it can be written as 1 minus log 3 value. Log 3 value is given in the question, so pOH value becomes 1 minus 0.48. And what would be this value? This becomes 0.52. So pOH is 0.52. What would be pH? pH is 14 minus pOH. And here it is 14 minus 0.52. And this is equal to 13.48. This is the pH of this given solution after neutralization. So here is option 2. That's correct for this question. Just choose it as your correct answer. After that, question number 83. Which alkali metal pair does not form superoxide? If we talk about alkali metal, large size alkali metal forms superoxide, like rubidium, like cesium, even potassium also. But if we talk about sodium and lithium, they are not forming superoxide. And on that basis, your option 3 becomes correct answer for this question. Let's take next question. Which among the following is incorrect statement? Solubility of barium sulfate is more than magnesium sulfate in water. Yes, beryllium, more hydration would be there. That's why its solubility is more. This statement is correct statement. I'll mark here a tick further. Thermal stability of barium carbonate is more than the strontium carbonate. Thermal stability depends on the atomic number in a particular group. As you move down the group, thermal stability of the compounds of the element increases. That's why this is also correct. Further. Beryllium hydride can be prepared by the reaction of beryllium chloride with lithium aluminum hydride. Yes, this is the preparation method for BeH2. Barium imparts brick red color to the flame. No, barium imparts apple green color, not the brick red color. That's why this is wrong statement. So, option 4 becomes your correct answer for this particular question. After that, question number 85. Dead burnt plaster is. Dead burnt plaster is obtained when gypsum is heated above 273 Kelvin temperature and there is the formation of CaSO4 and whole the water of crystallization is removed from it. So, CaSO4 is dead burnt plaster. That's why option 3 becomes your correct answer.